confusion. A fellow lost his watch in the railway station. What a confusion. A fellow lost his watch in the railway station. A saga girl named Imelda was suspected of being the burglar. She had no purse, no pocket in her clothes, but where she had the watch, only goodness knows. And they're hearing tick, tick, tick. Everybody looking tick, tick, tick. See them how they're searching tick, tick, tick. That's all they're hearing, but they couldn't find out where the watch was hiding. Under suspicion, they took her down to the police station and sent for the matron to examine every piece of clothes that she had on. The matron examined with care. She even made her pull out her long hair. She searched till she couldn't search no more, but the watch now ticking louder than before. And the hearing tick, tick, tick. Everybody looking tick, tick, tick. See them how they're searching tick. That's all they're hearing, but they couldn't find out where the watch was hiding. The matron hit on an idea that she could find the watch around somewhere. She said she had an incentive. She could find the watch she'd given privilege to divest Miss Melda entirely and search her as if she was crazy. The search was such. So they decide that the matron turned Melda's inside outside. And they're hearing tick, tick, tick. Everybody looking tick, tick, tick. See them how they're searching tick, tick, tick. That's all they're hearing, but they couldn't find out where the watch was hiding. Now in the station, the matron searching by inspiration. The watch ticking louder and louder, and the matron moving up closer. The matron convinced there's no doubt. She pushed her hand up inside Melda's mouth. And do you know, her idea came true, for when she found the watch, it was 10 to 2. Still ticking, tick, tick, tick. Everybody looking, tick, tick, tick. See them how they're searching, tick. That's all they're hearing, they now find out where the watch was hiding.